In our last video, we showed how you can use a liquid pressure sensor to manage filling of a remote tank. That video also explained how to install and configure the liquid pressure sensor. In this example, we will demonstrate how to manage filling of multiple tanks from one pump while protecting the pipework. For this, we'll use the liquid pressure sensor in constant pressure mode. So let's imagine a scenario where we are filling three tanks. The tanks are different distances and elevations away from the pump. Each tank has a float valve installed. The float valve will stop the flow of water when the tank is full. Now consider the behaviour in the pipework. As each tank fills, the flow through the pipe will effectively be reduced and the pressure will rise. It could be that the pressure increase could damage pipework. As the tanks will be filling or full at different times, the flow and pressure in the pipe network will be constantly changing. What we'll do is ask the pump to work in constant pressure mode so that no pipework will be damaged, irrespective of the status of the float valves in the remote tanks. So I'll connect to the pump with pump scanner, go to feature settings, control by pressure, analog one, and choose constant pressure. Now we're going to set our target pressure to be close to the maximum pressure that we want any part of the pipework to reach. In this case, we'll use 1 bar. The ramp speed tells the controller how quickly it should adapt to changes. We'll use 6 in this example. Higher numbers mean faster acting, lower numbers mean slower acting. We also want the pump to stop completely when all tanks are full. So here we'll set a maximum pressure threshold of 1.3 bar. I'll also set a 1 minute delay before our pump restarts so we can see the behaviour. And we save, and I'll go to actual data. We can see the pressure in the pipe being measured on analog 1. With all of the valves open, the pump will run as fast as it can to try and achieve our 1 bar pressure. I now start to close the valve. This simulates one of the tanks in the network becoming full. We see the pressure rise, and the controller will slow the pump to keep the pressure at 1 bar. We are maintaining the pressure at 1 bar to ensure that we don't damage any pipes. Now I can close the valve further as we simulate tank 2 filling. Again, the pump slows. Now the third tank fills and the valve shuts. The pump switches off. The valves will open as the water in the tanks is used. Pressure in the pipes drops and the pump is ready to go again. We can see the pump is in a 1 minute delay as the green light is flashing, indicating it's ready to go but waiting. So here you can see how a complex situation such as filling multiple tanks can be managed using a liquid pressure sensor on any Lawrence pump controller. And there our pump runs again and finds the correct pressure point.